one day. Waffle little guy. Cruising in the car. 60 at 2200. So we just took approximately, this is going to be like a 60-mile trip. Went down the North Shore, crossed over to the South Shore, went to a pet store, got a, what kind of, yellow something, 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 rasp, and something, 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 frag. And now we're heading back down the South Shore. We're going to hit up 231 and we're going to go back. I live on the middle of the island. So, the American out. And, we're just enjoying our Sunday. Taking a Sunday cruise.
Okay, we're back out here. I'm gonna work on the bottom here. This is gonna require a little bit more scuffing. It's all covered with rubber. Which should come right off. These are my plans. They could change. I'm gonna finish sanding on the side of this car. I'm gonna mask it off, just the side, epoxy it. After I epoxy it, I'm gonna glaze this section right there. Shouldn't require much at all. Block it down. After that, I'm gonna, I can maybe re-epoxy that area, whatever. And then I'm gonna slick sand the side of the car and go for, I don't know how many times on the fender, but the rest of the body should just be one blocking down. Then re-epoxy it, and maybe at that particular point, just do the side of the car satin black. Break the car into sections. So, then have the whole left side of the car done. Hey Ruben, at this part of the video, I think you should just fast forward, as I don't think you're ever going to suffer from excessive rubber on the quarter panels. But I could be wrong. There's always the chance where you buy one of my cars and you gotta peel the rubber off. So it's actually coming off better by just rubbing it than when it was sanding it. There you go.
Okay, we got this lower part done right into the curve. Same up here. I'll take care of more of that when I go around the back of the car. Got it up to like right here. Do this on the lip and then down in the bottom. Now, I don't want you guys to mistake what I meant, what I said when I said orange peel is not an option. If there's orange peel and I don't get it, that means I didn't prep the paint for the next paint. So if I do it and there's an area of orange peel, every part of those low spots, there's no way for the paint to adhere to. That's why I said orange peel is not an option. So I did this till I just started seeing the other color. I guess prime or whatever's under this coming through. So let me work on this lip around here. Then there, move forward. So that's it guys, looking good. Definitely looking good. Okay, we're getting there. This sucks doing the lower part sitting here like this. Even with the car raised up. Discovered a couple things. Forgot about this little ding I got in the rocker. That's about really all I discovered. So, in this forward edge right around here, I'm gonna get when I pop the fender off. And I'll get right to the edges of like the door gaps and stuff like that. I don't wanna go too far around. This is definitely not a jam shooting deal. Jam's already black. So, but yeah, the lower part of the car is always the dirty and nasty. So, figure the flatter I get the paint now, the less orange peel I have in it now, the less orange peel that'll be in the stuff that I have to, sand before I paint. That's the bottom line. So, I think we're good. Definitely a solid car. I know the rock is as solid as a rock. When I moved the B-pillar back, I had to cut a gaping hole in the top of the rocker. Not even sure how big it was. It was pretty big. It was almost the width of the rocker on the top, and had to be a good 7-8 inches long. and you were able to see inside the rockets, and there wasn't even surface rust in there, so my rockets falling out of the car is definitely not a problem. So, and I cut all the rockets out of the other car, so I have actually pieces to patch these things. They don't make any of that, you know, for any future projects. And that's what I did. I trimmed the piece out and grafted it in, so you never know. So, but I'm definitely satisfied. Very minimal stuff. I should be able to knock the little bit of skimming I gotta do out in a couple hours when I do it. So, and like that little ding down there, and the skim over there is gonna be nothing. So I think overall we're doing good. I want to get the tires changed on this car, the back tires, so I get in the well and work. And I wish I had new, different front tires to put on in case anything happens. I don't want to damage those rims. Those rims aren't that cheap anymore. But I don't have any. That's a Chevy bolt pattern up front. So I am not switching 10 studs to put make it back to a Ford bolt pattern or AMC. Anything that'll fit, except those Unilock chrome things, and I don't even know if they'll clear the calipers. The car's got 12-inch rotors on it. So, but other than that, you can hear I'm wound down and just a little tired. So we had a very good day. We couldn't get up in the morning for the show. I could, Junior couldn't. So we decided to take the car for a ride anyway. And like I said, I put the 60 miles on it today. Stopped at the fish store all the way out east. Then we came home. He started to drip acclimate the fish, which is when you mix the old water and new water very slowly before you put them in the tank so they're accustomed to it. And while we did that, we took the go-kart mini bike out for a ride. Then you working on the tank and I'm out of here. For anybody keeping track, at least there was people early on the different years of this car. Bag is a 64, this part of the corner panel is a 69, doors are 69, the fender's a 64 and a 65, the rear axle's a 68, transmission's a 74, the block is a 74, the heads are a 70, the axle's a 42, and I think that's it on there. Different years. I got something in here from the 66 wagon. I don't remember what it was. The gate's original. So, I know the ladder bars came off a 68 Chevelle. And they were shortened down 3 inches. Way back when. I guess that's about it. A lot of different years. As far as I know. The intake manifold was made in 1973 by Edelbrock, I know that. That's about it. Oh, the Magneto's in 1968, because I got the box, the original box. Then it was modified in 1968. But I, like I said, I had it updated, or tuned, when I put it in. So, I keep it vintage.